Help me, Dr. Zaius!
Dillyframe Games have made a lot of bunny games, but quantity should never be placed above quality. At least they have the decency of writing a brief, yet honest description of Kick It Bunny. Solve block puzzles in the bunny world by kicking it, restoring the figures. You can play the game alone or with friends. You can read more about the game on Steam, but since Dillyframe Games didn't include any story in the game, I'll not waste anyone's time talking about it. When you start Kick It Bunny, you're quickly loaded into the game world with no explanation or tutorial. What's immediately apparent is the low resolution and the assortment of brown textures covering the landscape. This extends to the world map, which also shows one tone of blue for the sea. This sticks out like a sore thumb compared to the drab landmass, but two wrongs don't make a right. On their own, these issues are unpleasant. However, it's the fact that the brownish player character blends into the environment, as well as the game emanating a warm, oversaturated, sunny glow that makes it difficult to look at. At least give your mascot a colour that stands out enough from most of the background. Speaking of which, setting the landscape in a desert and cranking up the saturation isn't an excuse for lack of colour and detail. That's gaming design 101. And for some reason, my gamer tag on the screen kept glitching. In this case, Dillyframe Games better hope none of their players are prone to having seizures. When a game causes eye strain from just looking at it, not many are going to want to play it, especially in an age where video game graphics are scrutinized down to the finite pixels. Meanwhile, Kick It Bunny looks like an early Xbox 360 game gone wrong. A ray of hope? Not all elements of Kick It Bunny's graphics are bad though. The sea demonstrates lovely shades of blue and white while it ripples smoothly, and the grass waves back and forth gently as if pushed by a gentle breeze. Not to mention, although the player model is simple, at least it's animated correctly for the most part. The rabbit's ears jiggle how you'd expect as it walks. The walking and swimming animations are a little too simple though. Speaking of the latter, when the bunny hits the water, it speeds off like a runaway jet engine. There's no in-between animation for transitioning land or water either. Your bunny can hop, as well as give a wimpy kick that sends enemies flying. It also stuns them for a few seconds before causing them to flee. Enemies can also do the same to you, though make no mistake, there's no death in Kick It Bunny. Even when your bunny falls off a cliff, it spawns right where it left off, accompanied by a sharp vibration in your controller. I recommend turning this off as vibration isn't implemented correctly. Rah rah ree, kick him in the knee. The meat and potatoes of Kick It Bunny is solving block shape puzzles. Pressing X kicks a shape forward while B rotates it. Solving these puzzles through dragging and dropping would have made this a smooth experience. Unfortunately, Dillyframe Games doesn't agree with me on that. Instead, they'd rather have you kicking about each shape for a while, as well as rotating them with another kick. And with the puzzles being quite difficult, this makes experience both tedious and frustrating. This is further multiplied by the eye strain caused by the poor visuals. Outside of puzzles, players can jump through hoops which feel tacked on. The only instance I remember that being fun is in the Spyro series, where thought was put into the placement of the hoops, the environment and the obstacles. There's also football and a racetrack if you want to get your friends involved, but that's a big if. There's online multiplayer, but you shouldn't put anyone else through this pain with you. Another big problem with Kick It Bunny is it's a puzzle game that combines a 3D platformer with an open world setting. The game's trying to be too many things at once, and as a result, fails at everything. My advice for making future games is to start smaller. Just make a good game that's focused on one genre. Once they master enough genres, then Dillyframe Games can think about combining some of them into a project. Verdict. To be honest, I don't believe anyone should play Kick It Bunny for any price, let alone around $10. This is despite what you see on the internet of some people enjoying the game. If the team from Dillyframe Games watch this video, I hope they consider the criticisms I made and the changes I outlined for them. The biggest compliment I can muster with Kick It Bunny is the music. There's only two tracks, but the country guitar melodies are pleasant to listen to, Adding more music would have been a plus, though audio is the least of Kick It Bunny's problems. And as such, it gets a 1 out of 10. It is reprehensible. Looking at the subcategories, you're probably surprised at this score, but it's the fact that visuals cause so much eye strain that it's really not worth the experience. If they at least fix the saturation in the game and make the character stand out more so it's not a strain on the player's eyes, it wouldn't have got a 1 out of 10. Hello guys, hope you're having a fantastic day. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and to subscribe for more videos.